So what is scabies? Scabies is a contagious infestation of the skin by the human itch mite, Sarcoptes scabia varhominis. The microscopic scabies mite burrows into the upper layer of the skin where it lives and lays its eggs. Scabies infestation is frequently complicated by bacterial infection, leading to the development of skin sores that in turn can cause more serious consequences such as septicemia, heart disease, and chronic kidney disease. One of the most common dermatological conditions, accounting for a substantial proportion of skin disease in developing countries. Crusted Norwegian scabies. A severe form of scabies, it has thick crusts of skin that contain large numbers of scabies mites and eggs. It's very contagious to other persons and may not show the usual signs and symptoms of scabies, such as the characteristic rash or itching. It can be spread easily both by direct skin-to-skin contact and by contamination of items such as their clothing, bedding, and furniture. Persons with crusted scabies should receive quick and aggressive medical treatment for their infestation to prevent outbreaks of scabies. Norwegian scabies may occur in some persons who are immunocompromised, which means they have a weak immune system, the elderly, the disabled, or the debilitated. So how is scabies primarily transmitted? Well, it's usually spread by direct, prolonged skin-to-skin contact with a person who has scabies. The contact generally must be prolonged. Scabies is spread easily to sexual partners and household members. Scabies in adults frequently is sexually acquired. And scabies is less transmitted via contact with clothing, towels, bedding used by an infected person. The incubation period is usually between 2 to 6 weeks after being infested. It's important to remember that an infested person can spread scabies during this time, even if he or she does not have the symptoms yet. Remember that there is a period of communicability. Scabies is communicable until mites and eggs are destroyed by treatment. This is usually 2 courses, 1 week apart, and the itching may persist for 2 or more weeks after successful eradication of the mite. If a person has had scabies before, symptoms appear much sooner, usually 1 to 4 days after exposure. An infested person can transmit scabies even if they do not have symptoms, until they are successfully treated and the mites and eggs are destroyed. Itching is very common, and also a skin rash. Severe itching, especially at night, is the earliest and most common symptom of scabies. A pimple-like, papular, itchy, scabby rash is also very common. Itching and rash may affect much of the body or be limited to common sites, such as between the fingers, wrists, elbow, armpits, penis, nipple, waist, buttocks, and shoulder blades. How do we diagnose for scabies? Well, diagnosis is usually made based on the customary appearance and distribution of the rash and the presence of burrows. It's confirmed by identifying the mite, mite eggs, or mite fecal matter. This can be done by carefully removing a mite from the end of its burrow using the tip of a needle or by obtaining skin scraping to examine under a microscope for mites, eggs, or mite fecal matter. It is important to remember that a person can still be infested even if mites, eggs, or fecal matter cannot be found. Typically fewer than 10 to 15 mites can be present on the entire body of an infested person who is otherwise healthy. However, persons with crusted scabies can be infested with thousands of mites and should be considered highly contagious. How long can scabies mites live? Well, on a person, scabies mites can live for as long as 1 to 2 months. And off from a person, scabies mites usually do not survive more than 48 to 72 hours. They will die if exposed to a temperature of at least 50 degrees Celsius, that is 122 degrees Fahrenheit, for at least 10 minutes. What is the best treatment for scabies? Well, scabicides is usually found in a lotion or a cream. It's a medication used to treat scabies. Scabicides kill scabies mites. Some also kill mite eggs. It should be applied to all areas of the body from the neck down to the feet and toes. Available only from a doctor's prescription, no over-the-counter or non-prescription products have been tested and approved to treat scabies. For infants, only permethrin or sulfur ointment may be used, and all persons should be treated at the same time to prevent reinfestation. Let's talk about scabies prevention and control. Scabies is prevented by avoiding direct skin-to-skin contact with an infested person or with items such as clothing or bedding used by an infested person. All household members and other potentially exposed persons should be treated at the same time as the infested person to prevent possible re-exposure and reinfestation. Bedding and clothing worn or used next to the skin anytime during the 3 days before treatment should be machine washed and dried using the hot water and hot dryer cycles, or be dry cleaned. Items that cannot be dry cleaned or laundered can be disinfected by storing in a closed plastic bag for several days to a week. Scabies mites generally do not survive more than 2 to 3 days away from human skin. Persons with crusted scabies and their close contacts include household members, and they should be treated rapidly and aggressively to avoid outbreaks. Institutional outbreaks can be difficult to control and require a rapid, aggressive, and sustained response. Rooms used by a patient with crusted scabies should be thoroughly cleaned and vacuumed after use. Environmental disinfection using pesticide sprays or fogs generally is unnecessary and is quite discouraged.